In question number 10, a mass m is on a, an inclined plane of angle theta. If it begins to move, what is the maximum force of friction that is experienced by this? What is the maximum static frictional force experienced by the mass? Since the mass m is on an inclined plane, the force acting on the mass vertically downward is its weight, that is mg. Then we have already seen cases that this mg can be resolved into two components. One is the component perpendicular to the plane, which we call theta. If this angle is theta, so I have just drawn it a little bit longer, we shouldn't be drawing this. So one force, if this angle is theta, we know for sure that this angle is theta. The force, if the mass is m, the downward force is mg. Now this mg can have two components. One is along the inclined plane, one is perpendicular to the inclined plane. So like this mg, you can consider this as, we have actually seen this so many times, so I take the privilege of writing it directly. This is mg cos theta, then the downward force is mg sin theta. Then the normal reaction in this case is here is equal to mg cos theta. Then the normal reaction is mg cos theta. We know that frictional force is mu times normal reaction. Here the block is coming along this way, hence it is not jumping up or down in this way, then n must be balancing mg cos theta, or we can simply say that these two forces are balancing each other, then n must be mg cos theta. Then the maximum frictional forces, maximum coefficient of friction, which we call static friction, into normal reaction in this case is mg cos theta. You have to use caution. First thing is, if mg sin theta is far less than this value, suppose when there is no downward force, then the frictional force is zero. And frictional force is a variable force, remember that. If mg sin theta is less than this value means, then the frictional force will be equal to mg sin theta. Because if, for instance, if mg cos theta value is 100 and mu is, for instance, an example, for example, if mu static is 0.2 and mg cos theta in our case is 100, then frictional force, the maximum possible value of frictional force is 0.2 into mg cos theta, which is 20. Then if mg sin theta value, if, please watch this, if mg sin theta is equal to 10 newton, then frictional force is also 10, because the friction will only oppose the relative motion. If the downward force is mg sin theta, if that is equal to 10, the frictional force cannot exceed 10. If frictional force is 20, means it will move upward, so that cannot happen. So as long as this mg sin theta is greater and the body begins to move down, then obviously if the body slides down means mg sin theta is greater than mu mg cos theta. Then in such case, the maximum possible frictional force experienced by the block on this surface is static friction into mg cos theta.